Okay, you know what time it is. Forget it any way I can. Keep on rocking in the free world. 99 problems, but a mortgage ain't one. Keep on rocking in the free world. Keep on rocking in the free world. Keep on rocking in the free world. Let's start off with Daniel Pickering says, Justin, you have said a couple of times about the size of an RV. I'm just about to build one from scratch, and the van I have been looking at comes in either 19 foot 6 inches or 21 feet. You have said a couple of times in your videos about the ideal size may be something a little bit shorter. Do you think the extra space is worth the parking issue? I live near London, England, or should I just get the 19 foot 6 inches? Well, I can't speak for London, but I've heard that over there you guys have much smaller roads than we do here in Canada. But I can tell you just from personal experience that I've had regular 19-foot extended Dodge vans, and now I have this 21-foot Explorer. And that extra couple of feet, I mean, it will just fit into parking spots, but only assuming the people in front and behind are parked properly. Sometimes there's times when I can't get in. And if I was 1 foot shorter, I would be golden. So, I mean, the difference in space is negligible. I don't even need this much space. So, I mean, it's really on how much junk you're going to be hauling around. But I would say go with the smaller one, man. Next, 357 Buick says, just a couple of quick questions. What do you do in extreme weather? Where I live, we have tornadoes sometimes, but I didn't know about the weather in VC. I guess you mean Van City. Also, what is the height of your van? I know you said it would go through a drive-through, but was just curious as to overall height. Keep up the cool vids. We don't really have extreme weather here. Actually, it kind of makes me laugh all the time that whenever there's tornadoes, they always seem to hit the trailer parks. Like, these are the people that can move their houses. Why the hell would they park them in the middle of a tornado alley? But as far as the drive-thrus go, I don't know what the exact height is. I'll get out there with a measuring tape, I guess, when I get a chance, and measure it. But most drive-thrus don't have overheight restrictions. Some of them do. It's not the height that's the problem. It's the length in most drive-thrus. Even this one, I'll have to stop and back up to get around some of the curves. And sometimes one of the tires will go over a curb a little bit. So when I had my old 23-foot years ago, I couldn't get into most drive-thrus just because it was too long. So it's the length that's more important than the height. Obviously, if there's an over-height bar, you're not going to be going through, right? One Awesome Inch says, question, you say the chimney pipe is hot-ish to the touch. So by that, I assume you have to keep the pipe away from any insulation or plywood paneling materials. Just trying to figure out how the pipe is going to meet the ceiling. I plan to put the Dickinson P9000 in my van and E150 as well. He wants it because it'll fight the humidity, which, yes, it does. Now, again, the sides are cold. It's not like a wood stove. It's just think of it as a little plug-in electric heater. That's about the type of heat you get off of this. So it's not like a wood stove where you're going to die of being too hot. And the sides are cold. You can touch the side of it. There's some slight warmth on the top half. The bottom is bone cold. And the walls are fine. All you need is an inch or two on the sides. Going up the pipe gets warm to the point where you don't want to hold on to it. But I can still touch it without burning myself. You don't need much. I did send you the link on your YouTube comment there to check out the manual for this so you can see the clearances that you need. But you don't need much. It's nothing like a wood fireplace. Don't let the looks deceive you. It doesn't get that hot, okay? ShellyFunny19 says, I'm redoing interior of my 94 Southwind. The kitchen has laminate wood floor. I want to get rid of the carpet in the living area, and I'm thinking about installing rubber flooring. Bought in rolls anywhere from 3/8 inch to 1/2 inch. Any feedback on how you think this will work out in the new coach will be seriously appreciated. Thanks. I couldn't tell you personal experience because I've never done it, but I can tell you I've seen it. I've seen it done in a couple of rigs. One was in a motorhome, just the kitchen area. Another one was done in an entire camper van, front to back, and I thought it looked really cool. It's not for me. I prefer carpet. Obviously, I like the comfort aspect, but it's something, if I wasn't going to put carpet down, I would consider something like that too. So, I mean, just do a little Googling. I'm sure you'll find other people's experiences out there. But I can tell you it looked pretty awesome and it was easy to clean, right? Okay, that's it for this edition. Pop your comments below. Any good questions, I will get back to you on the next video. Keep on rocking the free world, everyone. I love you all.
Hey, so what do you think of van life?
Van life is fucking awesome.